Hi, I'm Ali Sealander with UTD Geonews, and I'm here to tell you about a trembler that rocked Texas recently.
A series of earthquakes in West Texas was felt throughout southern New Mexico and southeastern New Mexico today. The U.S. Geological Survey reports there were 5 quakes near Mentone, Texas.
A little after 10 in the morning on March 26, a moderate earthquake struck far west Texas, about 25 miles west of the small town of Mentone, Texas.
Shook up, an earthquake rattling the borderland this morning from hundreds of miles away. A lot of El Pasoans felt it.
The U.S. Geological Survey registering a 5.0 magnitude earthquake about 3 hours east of El Paso, north of Pecos, Texas. Now, this afternoon, local experts say it is not surprising to feel earthquakes in this area.
No damage or injuries have been reported in the Sun City.
No serious damage was done, partly because it was a moderate earthquake, a magnitude 5, and partly because the earthquake happened in the sparsely populated Chihuahuan Desert. Only 19 people live in Mentone, the only community in Loving County, Texas. Few people live in this region because it's a desert. However, people in El Paso, Texas, 175 miles away, said it felt like a large train was passing nearby. Even though this was a pretty modest earthquake as earthquakes go, it was one of the strongest earthquakes that Texas has experienced in the past 150 years. The earthquake occurred in a region of low seismic hazard compared to regions to the west, Oklahoma, and in the central Mississippi River Valley to the northeast. What do we know about this earthquake? The earthquake occurred in a region known as the Permian Basin. The Permian Basin filled up with 25,000 feet or 7.6 kilometers of sediment and contains some of the richest oil deposits in the world. According to the United States Geologic Survey, the earthquake occurred 3 to 9 kilometers, 10,000 to 30,000 feet, below the surface and was due to normal faulting on an east-west oriented fault, indicating that north-south stretching caused the fault to slip. There is no obvious candidate for the fault that moved to cause this earthquake, although faults that trend approximately east-west occur in the region. Smaller earthquakes or aftershocks continue, so the region seems to be settling back to normal. Scientists, however, have a lot of work left to do, especially to figure out if the earthquake was caused by natural stresses in the Earth's crust, or if it was induced, caused by increased oil and gas operations in the Permian Basin. I'm Ali Sealander, and I'll see you on the next UTD Geo News. Thank you.